Hey guys, Paul with you today. I'm going to talk about muscle imbalances. I got a ton of email asking that question. I got tired of answering it. Muscle imbalances is where you guys say, like, your right pectoral is more developed than your left, or your right bicep is bigger than your left bicep. There are two things I wanted to cover in this video. First is muscle attachment. That you can't change. If you can see, my chest is shaped more like a square. Other people, they have it shaped more as in round in the bottom, on the bottom. Another thing is my bicep. You can see it has a very small tendon right here. Very small tendon, and then the muscle begins. And then it stretches all the way here, and they have a very small tendon attaching. Many people, the tendon is bigger. So right here, the tendon would be bigger. Their muscle starts a little later, and then it goes, and then they have a big tendon here again. It's a very small difference, but it causes it's a very small difference in attachment, but it makes a huge difference in the way it looks. For example, you can see my bicep, it peaks, which is very different from most people. And that's genetic, you can't change that. That's tendon length. This is chest shape. That's muscle attachment. You cannot change that. Another thing is abs. My abs are pretty symmetrical. Most people, they have asymmetric abs, so they would have different attachments on both sides. Mine's are pretty symmetric, but not too symmetric. And that also you can't change, the attachment, but you can change the size. And how you do that? Most people, if you develop, for example, your right is bigger than your left, or your left is bigger than your right, how you change that? If you're using weights, it's super easy. You use the same weight in each arm when you're picking it up. Or instead of doing bench, try doing dumbbell flies, because you can't really cheat on that too much by putting more stress on one arm. When you're doing body weight, though, this is where much of this develops, is here's where the problem comes in, is when you do pull-ups, for example, and you, maybe it's unnoticeable, maybe it's very little, but in your head you're concentrating on pulling more with your right arm, and if you could see, my chest is going more towards my right side. To you, that would be your left, I think. So your head's coming right here, so this whole side and this lat is getting more of a workout than your left one, okay? And that could be a problem, because this arm is going to develop a lot more. And the way to fix that, obviously, is start doing pull-ups and concentrating on the side that's smaller and that's weaker. So if your left is weaker, you're going to start doing pull-ups, concentrating more and going to this side. If you're doing push-ups, you're going to concentrate more and coming down to this side. If you're doing dips, dips is very, very, very common. I see this. Whenever I see beginners doing dips, almost all of them, when they're doing dips, they're always going to one side. I see this all the time, and I always try to change it. So if you see, if you're doing dips, and one side is bigger, for example, your chest is more developed on one side, or your tricep is, or your shoulder, you start going to the other side. Or have someone check on your form and make sure you're doing proportionally on both sides and getting the same workout on both sides. And then another thing, so first we covered muscle attachment, now we're covering how to fix the imbalance. And third thing I want to cover is if your form is right and everything's going correct, you should be fine. But always have someone check on you and make sure you're doing it properly. There's another thing I wanted to cover. Size you can increase. You can't change the attachment, but you can always change size. And this is what you do by working out, okay? The last thing, so muscle attachment, fixing the imperfections, muscle size can be increased, and usually increasing muscle size makes it look more proportional, and you can't see those little things such as having a small tendon. If your muscle is really big, it increases the cross-section area, it'll look much bigger. Professionals or like bodybuilder judges, they would be easily able to tell the difference. But overall, you look much more proportional. For example, if your abs are very unproportional, just by working them out and getting them bigger, they'll just look more proportional, even though their attachment's messed up. And the last thing I want to talk about is concentrate in your head about flexing that muscle. For example, I can be going to my right side, but in my head, I'm concentrating on pulling my left more, so I'd be like, ugh. And even though I changed the side I'm going to, I'm still pulling with this arm much more. Sorry, I'm pointing out my chest. My chest is not really getting worked in this exercise on pull-ups. So I can be going like this and pulling with my arm and lat a lot more on this side. Or I could be doing push-ups, I mean be going on this side, but in my head I'm pushing a lot more with this arm rather than my right. So here it's very important that you use your brain to flex the right muscles. Okay, it was Paul with you today, and this is another video for you. I can't end this professionally. I have a video right here, my last video, which is abs challenge, Beamer's ab challenge, and I'll put a video right here on, I don't know, top three exercises for shoulders. I don't remember what I did other than that. All right, God bless you. Bye-bye.